So you are building the next amazing .NET cross-platform app with .NET MAUI for either mobile or desktop or both. However, getting the app UI to look good and performant can be a bit of a struggle. Telerik UI for .NET MAUI is here to help. So stay tuned to see how you can get started today. All right, folks, I am Sam Basu, dev advocate at Progress Software, mostly focusing on the Telerik side of UI tooling. So let's get started with .NET MAUI. And hopefully, I don't have to sell you on the promise. This has been out for a while. It's multi-platform app UI. It is the evolution of .NET cross-platform story to mobile and to desktop. You know, you've heard the promise, it's multi-platform, all from a single code base with truly shared resources, keeps developers very productive, and just a really rich ecosystem. And as we stand today and in early 2023, the tooling is, very stable on both Windows and Mac. So all of this is good, but you might need a little bit of help on the UI side, and that's where we would like to come in. So Telerik UI for .NET MAUI is a comprehensive UI component library specifically targeted for .NET MAUI, written from ground up. Everything is very native and performant. So there's a lot in it for you. So what are some things that you might want to just drop in and light up your apps with? So we got a lot of things in here for you. There are data controls that are very intensive, things like data grids and list views, which are, all very virtualized and very performant, very customizable. We have data visualization tools. We have, a variety of charts and graphs. And we have lots and lots of input controls and, navigation and layout controls. You get, the deal. It's a whole package for all of .NET MAUI controls that are just meant to keep you more productive as a developer. Now, before I show you any of this and how you can get started, it's good to know that you don't have to trust anything that I say here. Be it on iOS or Android or Windows, go to their app stores and check out some of these sample apps so you can actually see some of our UI in action without you first having to, get the bits and, get them in your app. So there is a MAUI Showcase control app, and there is a Crypto Tracker app. Both of these are in every app store. So go check it out. And also the source code is out on GitHub, so you can, see how we are rendering some of the UI, how a real world app that's in the store, how that works with design patterns, and how we are rendering some of this complex UI. So you can take a look at all of that. So let's just say you're sold and you want to get started right now. Now, there are a couple of ways in which you can get started today. So this is, the homepage for all of Telerik UI for MAUI, but maybe you want to start one level up. This is all of Telerik UI tooling. We have something called DevCraft, which is a bundle that includes all of our .NET and JavaScript tooling. If that's what you want to get started with, unless you are already, a user, then you likely have the subscription and all of the bits. But if you're, brand new getting started, then hit this big, red download button here. What it does, it's going to install, an installer on your machine, both Windows and Mac. And especially on Windows, it's going to give you like a little control panel, which lists out all of the products that you're getting and how you can manage their, life cycles as you get updates and so on. But that's, everything together. Let's just say you want to be a little bit more granular. So you just want to get started with Telerik UI for .NET MAUI. Now, once you sign up, and if you just want to sign up with the trial, that's fine. If you already have a Telerik account, then come into telerik.com and you want to log in. This little icon here tells you that I'm logged in. I have a few accounts here, but I'm, logging in as one that has just a customer account. And you can see all of my products are listed right down here. So now I can, drill down into Telerik UI for .NET MAUI. It's going to show you which one's the latest version, which is 5.0.1. And I can go download that. If I wanted to, I can go back in time as well. I don't recommend it personally, but if you are stuck with an older version and you just want to keep using that and not update to the latest ones, that's fine. You can go back and get the bits for that. But once you're on the download page for Telerik UI for .NET MAUI, you're gonna see a couple of packages. You might wanna get just a zip file, or if you're on Windows, you might wanna get that MSI installer, or if you're on Mac like myself, you can get the package. So those are all, just the installers that get you going. Now, once you run one of these installers, what do you actually get? So let me show you in my Finder here. I keep all of my stuff in a nice organized folder here, progress folder. And you can see I have lots of installations of Telerik UI and dotnet MAUI because I work with the product team. And we started way back in early 2021. I've had a whole bunch of previews, like 14 of them to go with all of the dotnet MAUI previews, starting with 0.0.1 semantic versioning all the way up until 1.0, which went with dotnet MAUI GA with dotnet 6. And right now, like I have the 5.0 as the last installed, version of the installer. So that's what I have. If you get the 5.01, which is the latest one, you're going to get another installer. So once you, run that installer, this is the folder that you get based on wherever you choose. Now let's take a look at what you get inside. So first thing is you get all the binaries for .NET 6 and .NET 7. We don't, hold you back. If you want to stay on .NET 6, that's up to you. Or if you want to go, on .NET 7 or even like bleeding edge up to .NET 8 previews, that's fine too. All of your binaries are right here. There are also the packages, which are the actual NuGet packages, the NupKeg files, which you can, import into your projects and get started. So there is nothing stopping you from copying some of these files over or the binaries into your existing .NET MAUI projects and running with it. But it's a little bit of manual work. We like to keep things a little easier for developers. But in here, before I go back to Visual Studio, there are also these examples. So the two examples that I talked about, the control sample and also the crypto tracker, these are the two exact apps that are in the app stores. And we give you the source code. They're also out on GitHub, but we give you the source code when you run the installers. So you can see exactly how we are rendering those UI. And it's a full-on project. You can open them up in Visual Studio and see exactly how all of the dependencies work and how we are wiring things up. So really nice way to kind of get used to the UI and then how we do things. But all of your things are right there, and you can bring them over into your apps as and when you need. However, like I said, that's a bit of a manual process. So most people, once you have our binaries and your subscriptions, then you don't have to go through the installers all the time. The easier way is to go through a NuGet package. So if I go back here to the documentation here, which we take this very seriously, that developers should not be struggling with our docs, with our support, with our example sample apps. We are here to make sure you are productive and you can get going as quickly as possible. So take a look at the documentation. There are download installation guides for Windows and for Mac and how you can get started. Download from an MSI file or just run the installer. There are some Visual Studio extensions that are there to kind of help you be just a little bit more productive with Telerik UI for dotnet MAUI. So all of this is just there to help you. But one of the easiest things I do is installing with NuGet. So there are clear documentations on how you do this. It's very, very simple. It's just a NuGet feed that we host, so you can get the binaries that much easier. So let me take you inside of Visual Studio. Just Visual Studio for Mac, you will have the exact same experience on Visual Studio for Windows. So let's just say I have already started a, a dotnet MAUI project, and now I'm realizing that I need some of that fancy polished UI that is performant and that just lets me drag and drop. There's a toolbox where you can just drag our UI onto your XAML pages. So all of that is there for you, but you have to actually get the bits first. So first thing I would do is go into my preferences, and you can see that I have a couple of NuGet sources set up. You can have your local NuGet sources. You can have NuGet packages that are coming from Visual Studio, App Center, or GitHub Actions, or Azure Artifacts, any of your sources. But we want you to install or add one NuGet source that is typical or particular to us. That is nuget.telerik.com/v3index.json. That is a NuGet source that we host, so you can get our binaries that much easier. So you add that the first time you sign in. It's going to ask for your credentials, and then that's it. That's all you need to get all of the binaries and the bits that you need from us just from one single source. So granted I have that, I can come into any dotnet MAUI project and just right click on my dependencies or on the project and just say manage NuGet packages. So now you can see that I have my package sources listed. I can go look through all of nuget.org, or I can flip it to the Telerik feed. Now, in this case, it's going to list out all of our binaries. This is all of Telerik's .NET tooling, so it's a lot, and you can trim it down to exactly what you want. If you want, you can go, you know, get the nightly builds or the pre-release versions of if you want. But let me do a search on MAUI, and right there is Telerik UI for .NET MAUI. Now, it does have some, you know, dependencies, and we're going to spell it out right there for you. And right here as well, you can actually go back in time. Let's just say you don't want to be on the latest one. You want to go back to 4 or 3, you can. So once you do that, you just want, you know, check off that button and then add package. That's all you need. And we're also, you know, kind of smart in how we, you know, package up this UI. If you are using Telerik UI for .NET MAUI, but then you just only use just one data grid in your app, you know, don't worry. We can do some pre-shaking and make sure your app package is not bloated. We only give you the binaries that your app absolutely needs. So once you, you know, add that, you should be all set. And we are going to make sure that we put in those dependencies in every one of the, you know, executable platforms and runtimes. So let's, you know, check out, you know, Mac Catalyst here. If I go look at NuGet packages, there, right there is Telerik UI for .NET MAUI. So I didn't have to move any files over manually. It's just there for me, just so much easier. So I can do this on every, you know, new project or existing project. But once I bring in those binaries in your MAUI program.cs, you do need, you know, use Telerik. Now it's using the .NET generic build, you know, host as the app kind of bootstraps. That's one extension method that just kind of wires up a whole bunch of things for you. So you should do that. And beyond that, it's just, you know, all of the controls that we do are ready for you. And once you can run the installers, there are Visual Studio extensions inside of it. So I can, you know, start up a new MAUI project right here and create a new MAUI project. This way, all of my Telerik dependencies are already there on a new project that I'm creating. So I don't have to go and get the NuGet packages. It's just right there for me. And again, once I have the NuGet packages, once I have my dependencies right, I can go, you know, render all of my UI. Here's a sample app that I'm working on, and you can see that I can, you know, come into any XAML view here, and I can just bring in my namespace to make sure I am talking to the right assembly. And then I can, you know, render whatever UI components I want. So here's a rad busy indicator that I'm, you know, rendering. Or here's a, you know, rad list view. Everything is rad, which stands for rapid application development. It's a, you know, fun little term that we, you know, keep using to just, you know, ensure that all of the developers are productive and you're using UI that's polished and it's, you know, nicely tuned up and performant for all of your, you know, mobile and desktop apps. And we are actually very careful as to how we render things here. So if I look at, you know, some of the more hard-hitting controls like a data grid, we are very, you know, conscious of the fact that you might be rendering this on a mobile surface area on iOS or Android, or that same data grid might be now working in a Windows app or a Mac desktop application, which is, you know, much more surface area, much more, you know, busy. So we will render our UI accordingly. So just to recap, there are three main ways in which you can get started. One is you can go and get the whole DevCraft bundle, or you can sign in and just get the installers that's going to get you .NET, you know, Telerik UI for .NET MAUI just on your machine, including the examples and the binaries and the NuGet packages. But that is, again, if you wanted to go run through the installers. Or you can just, you know, start with any existing or new .NET MAUI project and go get the bits from Telerik NuGet feed, and that's going to get all of your dependencies right in there. And you can go to Visual Studio Marketplace and get those extensions separately if you want. So, you know, we don't want to hold you back. Get started however you want, and, you know, start being productive. You have a toolbox, so you can, you know, drag and drop all of our UI. And our goal is to just essentially make .NET MAUI developers a little bit more happier, a little bit more productive for your mobile and desktop apps. So hopefully you have fun and go render all of our amazing UI, build the next generation of amazing apps. And, you know, Telerik UI for .NET MAUI is just here to help you be successful. So that's it from me. I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.